Hey my lovely YouTubers, it's me, Morgan Tracy J, coming today with a new word for you guys. And today I'm talking about the Proverbs 31 woman. We know the Proverbs 31 woman is a virtuous woman. We know she's a woman of worth. We know she's a woman of courage, of strength, and of dignity. But today I'm going to talk to you about how she is a woman of works. The Proverbs 31 woman is a woman of works, y'all. And if you read the chapter 31, you will see how much she is working. She's not only working for her husband and her children, but she's working for the future seasons to come. She's in the preparation and she's a visionary. She's a woman that knows what she's working towards. And I think that's what we as women need to acknowledge about a Proverbs 31 woman. She's a great housekeeper. She's bomb at that. But if you're someone who's like me, who's single or not married yet, or you know, who doesn't have children, then guess what? You can still take a lot from this verse outside of marriage, outside of children, okay? And I think the thing that stood out to me the most in this verse, in this chapter of Proverbs 31 woman, of Proverbs 31, is she examined her land. She examined her land, she bought it, and then she went ahead and started to work with her hands willingly. And I think this is something we can take back to our everyday life. If God has given us a vision or a desire, we have to always examine our land. If we want to step into something new, we have to be willing to examine our land to see what it is that we need to be moving towards. Also, then we have to make a decision based off of wisdom and the understanding of God. Make a decision, step into that decision in faith, and then we have to continue to work and believe in the decision that we made. That is a challenge, trust me. I have to do it all the time and it does scare me. But what I want to tell you is a way that I tied this into just like everyday life is I remember a time when I needed to buy a camera for my YouTube channel. And I had the extra money, but I was a little afraid to buy the camera. I didn't know if I wanted to drop that amount of money. Was it worth it? You know, but what I did is I examined the land. Was it beneficial? How was it going to get me closer to my vision? What could it do for me? Right? I examined my land and then I went out and I bought it. I didn't hear a voice of the Lord. I didn't hear God say, Morgan, buy the camera. I didn't hear that. But what I did is I examined my land and I made a decision based off of the wisdom of God and what God has previously shown me. That's what I made the decision off. And then it was time for me to work willingly. Just because I had the camera didn't mean everything was going to fall into place. I would have to set up times. I would have to record. I would have to learn the camera settings, learn editing equipment, learning how to edit, learning how to get lighting, all that stuff. I would have to learn. So that was me putting the work now, working willingly with my hands. And I think that's what Proverbs 31 women are. They are women who will examine their land. They are women who will step out in faith. And they are women that will work willingly. Because in the last verse of Proverbs 31, the last verse is Proverbs 31:31. That's how strategic God is. It says, give her the fruit of her hands. Because guess what? We will reap fruit on whatever we work on. Make sure you're working on things of God's mission. But when you are working in those areas, it says, give her the fruits of her hands. God wants to give you the good things. It says he will hold no good thing from you. So what are you working towards today? What are you putting your hands to work on? And when you acknowledge that, then be ready to receive the fruits of your hands. Because it says your works will praise you in the gates. So your works will start to come to light. It's the late hours you put in, those nights you stay up late and work, yeah, with no compensation, God says that your works will begin to praise you, not only in this life, but the next life. And that's what I want to tell you today. Do not grow weary in well-doing. Your works will praise you, sweetie. Your works, God says he wants to give to you the fruit of your hand. So you've got to be planting some things. You've got to be working towards something. If you truly want to reap the results that you desire, are your hands working? Is your mind working? Are you planting seeds of goodness? Are you working towards the things God has called you to do? Are you going into that vision? Are you examining your land on a daily? Are you saying, what is next? Let me overlook this land before I make a decision. Let me make sure I pray. And when I step out in faith, I can believe that the wisdom of God has been upon me. She fears the Lord. A woman to be praised fears the Lord. It doesn't mean she just knows the Lord. Oh no. It doesn't mean she just understands the Lord, but it says she has the wisdom to apply what she has learned. And so a woman that can examine her land, that can step out on faith, that can work willingly, that fears the Lord will receive what God has for her. And I think that's exactly what we need to be. A Proverbs 31 woman will not only work, but she will also receive the things that God has for her. And that's what we have to remember. All right, guys, I love you so much. Thank you for watching this video. I will see you in my next video. All right, be sure to like, subscribe, comment. Morgan Tracy J.